Nagash has unlocked the Night Vault and unleashed the vengeful spirits from within. Led by the Briar Queen, they scour the mirrored city for any who would defy the great necromancer. Now, in this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the Briar Queen, and by following these step-by-step instructions, you'll be able to paint any of the other spirits from the warband as well. So shake those pots, grab those brushes, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Corax White Spray, which is perfect for anything spirit-based. Now, the first colour we're using is Hexray Flame. Now, this is a technical paint, but it also works a bit like a wash. So first thing we'll do is just give it a good shake, just to make sure those bits mix together. And then I'm going to use a medium shade brush, just to start applying it to the palette. Now, the reason for this is, obviously, I want to coat it all over the model, but I don't want it to like splodge and just run uncontrollably. So I'm just going to balance that out by applying some to the bristles, but not so it's just pooling. And then we'll start actually applying it to the actual figure. I'm going to do this all over. I'm not going to worry about where it's going. This is the fun, messy part. So just literally slap it all on. And there we are with the Hexray Flame now applied and dry. We're going to move to the next step, which is to use Nighthaunt Gloom. And I'll continue using the same brush as well for this. So as before, just apply a little bit to my palette. And just give my brush a little bit of a spin just so I can just knock some of my excess off. And then what I'm going to do, so I'm just going to turn the model around and get to the back of the cloak. Now I'm going to start at the very base of the cloak, so it's going to be a bit darker down here. And we'll just work up a little bit. So I'm just going to concentrate, it's around the base of the cloak, like I said, but also I'll do some like the deeper recesses around like a tiara and stuff like that. But I'll use a smaller brush for that. I'm just going to wipe a little bit. We'll just do it on the inside as well. After applying the Nighthaunt Gloom, you can see it's added a lot of depth to the base of that cloak. I've also just applied a little bit in some of the deeper recesses around a tiara and veil. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use Ultramarine Grey. I'm going to highlight with this. Now I'm going to do two highlights. First of all, I'm going to start with a dry brush of Ultramarine Grey. When that's all done, I'm just going to use a small brush and just pick out some raised areas as a fine edge highlight. So start with that dry brush. I'm just going to apply a little bit to a small dry brush. Just apply a little bit like that. Rub it off as much as I can. Obviously, we don't want too much on the actual bristles itself. So just go backwards and forwards, swirl it around. And then what we're going to do, just grab the model. And I'm going to start at the top. I'm just going to gently work my way down. So actually, at the top, I can be a bit rougher, probably put a bit more pressure on. So actually, I'm just bending the brush a bit more like this when I'm doing it. I'll just really pick out some of those highlights. And as I get further down, like so, I'm just going to more like tickle it. I'm going to do this across all the areas. I'm going to do flesh. And obviously, with the hands and stuff like that, I'll give a bit more pressure on there as well to give a bit more highlighting. With the dry brush done, what we're going to do now is use Ultramarine Grey again. I'm just going to pick out some of the raised details and features like the face, like the hands and knuckles and such, just for some more controlled highlighting. There we are with the Ultramarine Grey highlights done. We're going to move on to the final highlight, which is White Scar. Now I'm just going to concentrate this on the skull and the arms themselves. What this will do is we'll just add a little bit more contrast to the actual skin and the skull and just make it look like a different texture from the robes itself. So I'm going to use a small layer brush for this. Just apply a little bit on my palette just so I can get a nice point. Just roll it around like so until you're happy with the point that you've got. And we'll just start doing it. So I'm going to do this around the eye sockets. A little bit finer than the previous colour. On the teeth as well. Then I'll pick out things like the knuckles. So I'll just turn it around so you can see a bit better. I'll just pick out the knuckles. And maybe any like veins or muscles or anything like that, or like sinew. With the White Scar highlights done, what we're going to do now is move on to painting the corset and the scabbard. Now for this we'll be using Rhinox Hide, and I'm going to be using a medium layer brush. I'm also going to thin it down a little bit more and do a couple of coats of it. So what I'm going to do is get a paintbrush of Rhinox Hide and a paintbrush of water. You'll notice it just moves around on the palette a little bit more freer. So this will just mean it will just run those recesses a lot easier as well. So what I'm going to do is just get it to a nice point, the bristles, and then we'll start actually applying it to the corset. Now you'll notice as well, there's like a little ropey bit of, I suppose you could say, belt. So I'm just going to try and avoid that as much as I can, because I want to keep that like an ethereal glowing kind of colour. So what I'm going to do is just neatly work around that. With it being thinned down as well, like I said, it just runs into those recesses a lot easier. So do this both on the corset And actually, when you paint the scabbard, it's just worth painting the whole thing because actually, there's details on there we can worry about later on when we come to them. There we are, with the rhinox hide now applied. What we're going to do now is move on to putting a wash on. This is going to be Norn oil. I'm going to do this on both the scabbard and the basque, as well as the little rope as well, the little rope belt that was on that figure. So what I'm going to do is use my medium layer brush, just apply a little bit to my palette, a little twist to get not too much knocked off, but just so there's enough on the bristles, and then just start applying it. So all I'm going to do is literally just slap it all over those brown leather areas, and like I said, that little rope area we left, I'm just going to apply it onto that as well, just to darken it down slightly. And there we are, with the Norn oil now dry, we're going to move on to highlighting the leather areas, and for this we'll start with Doomball Brown. So I'm just going to continue using my medium layer for this. Just add a nice little bit there and a little touch of water. Don't need too much. Just get a nice point, like so. We'll start highlighting it up. All we need to do is just work around the edges where you can see the raised details. I'm just going to start at the basque, like so. Start picking out those highlights. You don't have to go too mad. Pick out what you can see. Just do a little bit on the scabbard as well. And there we are with that highlight now done. We're going to move on to the final highlight, and we're going to use tusk or fur, and we're just going to concentrate this on the basque itself. We're not going to touch the scabbard at all. So I'm going to use a small layer brush for this. Apply a little bit to my palette. And again, just a touch of water, just to help it flow a bit. And again, just spin it around like so until I get a nice point to my bristles. And then what we're going to do, start highlighting it up. Now we're going to try and make this a little bit smaller than the last one, so I'm just going to like pick out almost corners if you like. So just on this basque area here, just a little bit there, a little bit there. There's also some thread as well, just going crisscrossing across. So I'll just pick those out as well. And there we are with the leather details now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the brass details. Now for this, we're going to start with Balthazar Gold as a base coat. We'll then shade those details using Agrax Surf Shade. To get some verdigris effects, we'll use Nylac Oxide, and to finish off with a highlight, we'll use Stormhost Silver. So for all of this, I'm going to use a small layer brush. Just going to apply some Balthazar Gold to my palette, and also a touch of water as well, just to allow it to flow a bit easier. I'll get a nice point to it as well. Now actually for the tiara, we probably want to be a bit neater, because at the front that's not so bad. When you get around the back, you've got a nice like fine little circlet that you need to paint. So just take your time when doing that. So first of all, we'll just apply some Balthazar to the front here. A little bit more water to my mix as well. And then like I said, when you get around to the side and the back, just be really careful. If you do make any mistakes, you can just touch it up with some Ultramarine Grey. With those brass details now base coated, we're going to shade them using Agrax Surf Shade. Again, just do that all over the gold details, or brass details, should I say. With the shade dry, what we're going to do now is use Nylac Oxide just to add a bit of verdigris to some of these brass details. So I'm going to concentrate on some of those deeper recesses just to give it a nice weathered effect. Also do it on the scabbard as well. To finish off the brass details, we're going to use Stormhost Silver. We're just going to highlight those raised details, mainly where the light will catch. So just on the raised areas on the tiara, like so. If it's the scabbard itself, just like some of the bits of the handle and the hilt. Maybe the odd rivet here and there. There we are with the brass details now done. We're going to move on to painting the thorns and the vines. Now for this we're going to start with Deathwood Forest. We're then going to shade it with a Thonian Camo Shade. I'm going to finish off with a couple of key highlights using Ogryn Camo. Now I'm going to use a medium layer brush for this. Apply a little bit to my palette like so, and a little touch of water as well. Again, this will help it flow. You can thin it down a bit more, but you'll have to do a couple of coats of it. But I'm just going to go for that. Seems happy enough with that. And then we're just going to start painting those vines. There's a few around, obviously just look at the model just to check out where they are. There's a couple of that just sneaked in at the back here as well, so don't forget those as well. With the thorns and vines now base coated, we're going to shade them with a Thonian Camo Shade. And again, I'm just going to apply this all over those vines. Once the shade's dry, we're then going to start using Ogryn Camo to highlight those thorns and leaves. So what I'm going to do is just pick out any like areas like the thorns like here, like leaves just here, but also just around the vines I might just like almost do like a little highlight just to pick out, give it a bit more shape, make it look like a vine. There we are, with the thorns and vines now done, there's only one detail left to paint, and that's the roses. We'll start with a base coat of Screamer Pink, we're then going to shade it with Druchy Violet, and finally we'll pick out those petals using a little bit of Pink Horror. So starting with that Screamer Pink, I'm just going to use my medium layer brush for this. Again, as always, a little touch of water just to thin it down slightly. Just give that a quick roll, get a nice point, and then we'll start picking out all those flowers. All we need to do really is just look where they are. There's obviously leaves as well that you may have painted, so just try not to get those confused with the flowers themselves. Just work around until you've done them all. With those roses now base coated, we're just going to shade them with Druchy Violet. And I'm just going to apply this all over the roses. In fact, if you just let it pool in them a little bit in the middle, that'll just give it a bit more depth as well. With the shade dry, now what we're going to do is pick out those petals using a little bit of Pink Horror. I'm just going to use the edge of the brush like so, or the side of the brush. That'll just help me pick out some of those raised areas. Obviously, for a little bit more fine detail, you can always use the tip of the brush, but I'm just not going to go too mad on these. When you've done these, just paint the base in the colour scheme that matches the rest of your wall bands. With the model now painted and based, the Briar Queen and a warband are ready to do battle in the Mirrored City. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when dry brushing, just build up those layers slowly. Try not to do it all in one go, otherwise you'll get some really stark and messy effects. And secondly, when using in shades, try not to overload your brush, otherwise it will pull in those recesses and it'll probably ruin your detail as well. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own warbands, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.